Hi and welcome to part 4, the final part of the blanket I love crochet. We start with 6 squares with a circle in the middle in 6 different colors. Then we make in different colors a lot of V-stitches and finally the border. Let's get started on part 4. We start on the first square. With the first color, make a magic circle on the hook. We start with a first double crochet, and that's a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. Now in the magic circle, we make 11 double crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, and the last one is 11. With the first chain 3 here in the beginning, now we have 12 double crochets in total. We close the magic circle, pulling that short tail here in the middle, and then on the top of the first double crochet, that's that chain 3, in the third chain stitch, make a slip stitch. Grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Before we start on round 2, we turn our work. After every round, we turn our work. We begin with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. The repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, make 2 double crochets in that same stitch. That's 1, back in that same stitch, and 2. Into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. And go under through that whole stitch, that V stitch. That's 1, back in that same stitch, and 2. This is the repeat you work all the way around. 12 times in total. Here on the beginning we have a chain 3, counts for 1 double crochet. We need to make 1 double crochet in that stitch more. But first we work all the way around, 2 double crochets in every stitch. That makes 24 double crochets in total. All the way around, 1 stitch to go, and that's on the same place that we make that chain 3 here. Counts for 1 double crochet, it must be 2 double crochets in 1 stitch. We make 1 more double crochet in that same stitch here under that chain 3, in this space here. Now we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first chain 3. And then we have 24 double crochets in total in this round. Round 3 and we turn our work and we begin with a first double crochet and that's a chain 3. 1, 2 and 3. On the end of this round we make 1 more double crochet in that same stitch here below that chain 3. but we start first on the repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, one double crochet, and then into the next stitch, two double crochets in that same stitch. That's one, back in that same stitch, two. And this is the repeat you work all the way around. Into the next stitch, one double crochet, into the next stitch, two double crochets. That's one, back in the same stitch, and two. Work all the way around, and in the beginning, we make one more double crochet. I'm done with the last repeat, one double crochet and two double crochets, into the next stitch, one double crochet, and then into the same stitch where we make that chain three, we make one more double crochet in that same stitch. It must be a group of two here. That's two double crochets. So one double crochet, two double crochets. On the top of that chain three, make a slip stitch. Now we have all the way around 36 double crochets in total. Round 4, turn your work. And we start with a chain 3. 1, 2, 3, counts for a first double crochet. On the end of this round, we make also one double crochet in that same stitch. The repeat of this round. Into the next 2 stitches, 1 double crochet. Then into the next stitch, we make 2 double crochets in that same stitch. Into the next stitch, one double crochet, into the next stitch, one double crochet, into the next stitch, two double crochets in that same stitch. And this is the repeat we work all the way around. One double, two doubles. Into the next stitch, one double crochet, and in the next stitch, one double crochet, into the next stitch, two double crochets. Work like this all the way around, and then in the beginning we make also one more double crochet. I'm done with my last repeat. One double, two doubles in that same stitch. Then the last repeat, one double into the next stitch. Also one double into the next stitch, and one more double on the here under that chain three in that same stitch. That's two double crochets in that same stitch. And we close this round with a slip stitch on the top of that chain three. Turn your work. We begin on round 5 with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. On the end of this round, we make also one double crochet in that same stitch. The repeat of this round. Into the next 3 stitches, 1, 2, and 3, we make one double crochet. And then into the next stitch, we make 2 double crochets in that same stitch. One double crochet in the next stitch, one in the next, and also one in the next, and then 2 double crochets in the next stitch. It's one and two. This is the repeat you work all the way around. One, 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 and two double crochets. Work like this all the way around and then make, yeah, in the beginning also one double crochet in that same stitch of that chain 3. My last repeat. Into the next 3 stitches, 1 double crochet. And then in the next stitch, that's under that chain 3, also 1 double crochet. So we have 2 double crochets in that same stitch. On the top of that chain 3, make a slip stitch. On the end of this round, we have 60 double crochets in total. Round 6, turn your work and we start with a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet. And also on the end of this round, make 1 double crochet in that same stitch here in the beginning. The repeat of this round. Into the next 4 stitches, 1 double crochet, and then into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. 1 and 2. Repeat these stitches all the way around. 1, 2, 3, 4 double crochets, and in the next stitch, 2 double crochets. On the end of this round, make 1 double crochet here. The last repeat. Into the next 4 stitches, 1 double crochet. And then here under that chain 3 in that same stitch, make 1 more double crochet. On the top of that chain 3, make a slip stitch. Now we have 72 double crochets in total. The last round of the circle. Turn your work. Begin with a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet. On the end of this round, make also 1 double crochet more in the same stitch here. The repeat of this round. Into the next 5 stitches, 1 double crochet. Then into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. One, two, three, four, and 5. Then into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in the same stitch. That's 1, back in the same stitch, 2. This is the repeat, you work all the way around. On the end of this round, make 1 more double crochet. Almost done with the stitches of this round. One more repeat to go. In the next 5 stitches, 1 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then into the next stitch under here of that chain 3, one more double crochet. On the end of this round we have 84 double crochets in total. We close with an invisible join, cut the yarn, open up that stitch, then with the needle we skip the first stitch, that's the chain 3. On the top of the next stitch, that's the first double crochet here, on the through the V stitch, the front to the back. Pull through, back to the last double crochet, on the top, only in the back loop. Pull through, not too tight. This is your invisible join. On the back I wave the tail in, but first I make a little knot under through one thread. Pull through, under through that same thread, one second time. Make a little loop, under through that loop, then pull, and then wave the tail in, only in the back of the stitches. And wave in also that little tail here in the middle of the magic circle, only in the back of the stitches. Round 8, we start with a new color, and this color we made from every circle and square. Make a slip knot on the hook. We must work in the back of the stitches. This last round that you see here is the front of the stitches, and these are the back of the stitches. We work in the back of the stitches. And we begin in a stitch with a standing treble crochet. Yarn twice over the hook. Enter your hook in a stitch. Under through that whole stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two. Back in that same stitch we make a treble. Yarn twice over the hook, enter your hook in that same stitch and make a treble. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2. Go back in that same stitch with another 2 treble crochet. That's 1. Yarn twice over the hook and make a treble. That's 2. And this is your first corner of the square. We make in the next 2 stitches also 1 treble stitch. That's 1. Also into the next stitch, 1 treble. Into the next 3 stitches, 1 double crochet. That's 1, 2, and 3. Into the next 3 stitches, 1 half double crochet, yarn over, and you can the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 3. That's 1, 2, and 3. Into the next 4 stitches, make 1 single crochet. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Into the next 3 stitches, 1 half double crochet, 1, 2, and 3. In the next 3 stitches, 1 double crochet, 1, 2, and 3. In the next 2 stitches, we make a treble crochet, twice over the hook. That's 1. Into the next stitch, also 1 treble. And in the next stitch, we make a corner. These all stitches we repeat 3 more times. And we start the next repeat with the corner. The second repeat, into the next stitch, 2 trebles in that same stitch. That's 1. And 2, then in chain 2, 2 trebles back in that same stitch. Into the next 2 stitches, also 1 treble. In the next 3 stitches, a double crochet. In the next 3 stitches, a half double crochet. In the next 4 stitches, a single crochet. In the next 3 stitches, a half double crochet. In the next 3 stitches, a double crochet. In the next 2 stitches, a treble. And in the next stitch, we make a new corner. Repeat all these stitches 2 more times. So 1 repeat, 2 repeats, 3 and 4. I'm almost done with the round. The last 2 stitches are a treble. To close this round, we make on the top of that first standing treble crochet a slip stitch. We start on round 9. Turn your work And we begin with a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet. Into the next 5 stitches, 1 double crochet. One, two, three, four, and 5. Into the next 10 stitches, we make 1 half double crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Into the next 7 stitches, we make a double crochet. Bring us to the next corner. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the last. That's on the top of the last treble for the corner, chain 2 space. Now we make in that chain 2 corner space a new corner. 2 double crochets in that space. That's 1 and 2. Make a chain 2 and back in that same space 2 double crochets to complete the first corner. We start on the repeat that we make 3 more times. Into the next 7 stitches, 1 double crochet. One, two, three, four, five, six, and 7. Into the next 10 stitches you work 1 half double crochet, and then the last 7 stitches for the corner a double crochet. Then in the chain 2 corner space we make a new corner of 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets. Repeat all these stitches all the way around, and then we make a slip stitch in the beginning. I have to make 1 more last corner. 2 double crochets in that chain 2 corner space. And chain 2. 2 double crochets back in that same corner space. After this last corner, we have to make 1 more double crochet in the last stitch. This is 1 double crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 double crochets. Make a slip stitch on the top of that 3rd chain stitch in the beginning. Then turn your work and we start on round 9. And we begin with a chain 3. counts for a first double crochet. Into the next three stitches, make one double crochet. One, two, and three. In that chain two corner space, we make a new corner of one double crochet, then a chain two, and one double crochet. This is your first corner. Now from the beginning to the end to the next corner, that's 28 stitches. We make in every stitch one double crochet. 28 double crochets in total. That bring us to the next corner. This here is your first stitch. That stitch after that chain two. Twenty-eight double crochets bring us to the next corner. And 28. Then in the next chain two space, we make a new corner of one double crochet in that space, and chain two, and one double crochet in that same space. Repeat all these stitches after that corner all the way around. After the last corner here, we make only 24 double crochets, and then we close with a slip stitch. I made after the last corner 24 double crochets. In the beginning, we work already 4 double crochets. That's 28 in total. Make a slip stitch on the top of the first chain 3 in the third chain stitch. And then we have to make one more round and then the square is complete. Round 11, turn your work and start with a first double crochet. That's a chain 3. Into the next 25 stitches, make one double crochet. That brings us to the next corner. In that corner, you make a new corner of one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet. Then in the next 30 stitches, one double crochet. In the corner, one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet. 30 double crochets, a new corner. Then also 30 double crochets, a new corner, and then on the end of this round, we make only 4 double crochets. Then we close with an invisible join, and then we're done with the square. I'm done with all the stitches all the way around. After the last corner, we make only 4 double crochets. We make an invisible join in the top of the first double crochet. Cut the yarn, open your stitch, we skip the first chain 3. This is the first double crochet, then on the top of the first double crochet. Go back to the last double crochet. Only in the back loop. Weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. The first square of 6 squares are done. Now we have to make 5 more squares. After we're done with the 6 squares, then we join all the squares together with slip stitches. The first 2 squares. And we make slip stitches from corner to corner. With the next color on the hook, with the slip stitches, we work only in the back loop of the whole stitch. You see here the chain 2 and then the first chain stitch for the first double crochet, that's the place where we start. Also from the other square, we have here 2 chain stitches, 1 chain stitch for the double crochet, that's the place where we start. The color is on the hook. And we begin in the back loop of the first chain stitch for the double crochet here, this stitch here, then only in the back loop. Your working thread must be under your work. Then the other square, the chain stitch for the first double crochet in the corner, and then only in the back loop of that stitch. We have now 3 loops on the hook, then yarn over and pull through all the loops on the hook. This is your first join stitch. We go to the next 2 stitches. After that, chain 2, the first double crochet on the top, only in the back loop. And only in the back loop of the next square, only in the back loop of that stitch, yarn over and pull through 3. Go to the next stitch, only in the back loop, enter hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull through. Work like this to the other corner. And make your join stitches not too tight. My last stitches for the next corner. It's the last double crochet for the chain 2 space. Then we have to make 1 more join stitch in the first chain stitch after that last double crochet. Only in the back loop, yarn over, pull through. Make a chain stitch. Make a little knot and cut the yarn. Now we join the squares on the blanket, on the last row of the blanket, and we do not turn the blanket. We want to work in the front of the stitches, also the front of the stitches of the squares. The color is back on the hook, and we begin in the square, in the chain 2 space, in that first chain stitch for the first double crochet. That's the point where we start, and then also only in the back loop of the stitch. Then on the top of the first double crochet, that's in chain 3, in the third chain stitch, also only in the back loop. Your working thread is under your work. Now yarn over and pull to 3. 1, 2, and 3. This is your first join stitch. We go to the next 2 stitches. The first double crochet after that chain 2 space. That's the next stitch, only in the back loop. And the next stitch of the blanket. Yarn over and pull through 3. Work like this all the way up to the end. And don't forget to make your stitches not too tight. Work like this all the join stitches to the next corner. And then I'll show you how you jump over to the next square. Almost on the end of the first square. One double crochet for the chain 2 corner space. Now the next stitch is that chain 2 in the back loop of the first chain stitch after that corner. We make also a slip stitch. Then we skip over to the next square. Then the chain stitch for the first double crochet here. And into the next stitch of the blanket, make a join stitch. Work like this all your join stitches. That's 204 join stitches in total. I'm almost on the end. Three stitches left over, and also here a double crochet, and a first chain stitch after that last double crochet. That's also 3 stitches. Then the last double crochet for the chain 2 corner space. And in the next stitch. And now in the last stitch, that's the first chain stitch after the last double crochet. Only in the back loop and in the last stitch of the blanket. This stitch here and on the top of the last stitch. Make one chain, pull a little knot and cut the yarn. And now you weave in all the tails here with a needle. You go under through that join stitch, that V stitch here, then through the back. Under through that V-stitch. Like this. Then through the back. Then we pull through to the back. Like this. This is how it looks like on the front. Now on the back we make a little knot, go under through a little stitch. Pull through for a second time, under through that same stitch, make a loop. Go with your needle through that loop and pull. Now weave in that tail on the back of the stitches. Row 125 with a new color on the hook. And you see I turn my blanket, I'm working on the back of the stitches. We begin with a standing double crochet in the chain stitch for the first double crochet, the stitch here. But now we work on the through that whole stitch. That V stitch of that chain stitch here, both loops, yarn over, pull up and make a double crochet. Now into the next 32 stitches, make one double crochet. That's one, two, and three. Work under through both loops of that whole stitch. 32 double crochets. I'll show you how we crossed over to the next square. I'm almost on the end of the first square. Two more stitches to go. And on the top of the last double crochet for the chain 2 space. In this row we have to make 204 double crochets in total. If we work further in every stitch with one double crochet like this in the next corner here, and also we skip that join stitch here in the middle, we go to the next stitch of the chain 2 and we work a double crochet. Then you see that we have a big gap here in the middle. We don't want that. We want to make a smaller gap here in the middle. Make a last double crochet on the top of that last double crochet here for that chain 2 corner. To make a smaller gap, we make 2 double crochets together in the chain 2 space and in this stitch here. Yarn over. Enter hook in the chain 2 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over into the next stitch, here for the join stitch here, Jan over, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Three loops on the hook, yarn over, pull for three. We make another two double crochets together, yarn over, enter your hook in the stitch after the join stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for two. Then yarn over, enter your hook in the chain two space of the next square. Yarn over, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Yarn over, pull for three. Now you work in the next 32 stitches on the top of each double crochet on the two both loops of that whole stitch, one double crochet, all the way up to the next corner. Then you work again two times two double crochet together in the corners. Make all these stitches all the way up to the end of this row. One stitch to go after the last double crochet in the first chain stitch in that stitch, one double crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next row we use the same color. Turn your blanket. With the same color we start with a first double crochet, and that's a chain three. The repeat of this row. We skip the next two stitches, one and two, and then in the next stitch we make a V stitch. A double crochet in that stitch, skip two, double crochet, then make a chain one and back in that same stitch with another double crochet. And this is the repeat we work all the way up to the end. Yarn over, skip two stitches, into the next stitch, a next V stitch of one double crochet, and chain one, and one double crochet in that same stitch. Yarn over, skip two stitches, double crochet in the next stitch, and chain one, double crochet in that same stitch. I made my last V stitch, two stitches over, we skip one stitch, and then on the top of the last stitch we work one double crochet. Make a chain and cut the yarn. And don't forget to weave in the tails. We start with the slip knot on the hook with the next color, and we begin with a standing double crochet on the top of the first double crochet. Then the repeat of this row. We make a V stitch into the next chain one space of that V stitch here below. Yarn over, enter hook in that V stitch, make a double crochet, then a chain one, and a double crochet in that same V stitch, the chain one space. Then in the next V stitch here in that chain one, make a new V stitch of one double crochet and chain one, one double crochet in that same space. In the chain one of the next V stitch, a double crochet, a chain one, and a double crochet all the way to the end. On the end of this row, after that last V stitch, we make a double crochet on the top of that chain three. Row 128 with the same color, return our work, and we begin with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet, the repeat of this row into the V-stitch, a new V-stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in that same space. Into the next chain 1 space, a new V-stitch. This is the repeat, you work all the way up to the end. Double crochet in the next V-stitch and chain 1, double crochet in the same space of the V-stitch. After the last repeat, you work 1 double crochet on the top of the last double crochet. Cut the yarn and weave both tails in. We made a lot of V-stitches. We have one more row to go with the same color, and we make in every stitch a double crochet. That's 204 double crochets in total, and we start of course with a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. We make in every stitch 1 double crochet, and we make also 1 double crochet in the first stitch. In this stitch here, also 1 double crochet. Then on the top of the first double crochet of that V stitch, 1 double crochet in that chain 1 space. And into the next stitch, the double crochet of the V stitch, 1 double crochet, and this is to repeat your work all the way up to the end. 3 stitches on that V stitch, the first on the top of the first double crochet, the second in that chain 1 space, and the third one on the top of the second double crochet of the V stitch. Repeat this all the way up to the end. almost on the end of this row. My last stitches here. Double crochet on the top of the double crochet of that last V stitch and also on the top of the last double crochet. Then make a chain, cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of your work. We have here all the V stitches and the squares with the circle in the middle. We have one thing to do. Let's make the border. Round one of the border, we do not turn the blanket. You see here the front of the stitches of the last row that we made. And we begin here in the chain 3 on the top of the third chain stitch with a new color on the hook. And we make on the top of that chain 3 a standing single crochet. In the next 203 stitches, we make one single crochet on the top, on the through that V stitch of the double crochet. In every stitch, one single crochet. So we have on the end 204 single crochets in total. That's including that first standing single crochet. Almost done. My last single crochets. Two more stitches to go. On the top of that last double crochet here. That's 204 single crochets. Now turn your blanket a little bit and we're going to start to work on the long side of the blanket, but first we make a corner. Make a chain 2. It's 1 and 2. Now we go around that first double crochet here. Around that stitch we make 2 single crochets. That's 1 and 2. These 2 single crochets, we repeat these 16 more times, so we have 32 single crochets in total. Around the next double crochet or on chain 3, make 2 single crochets. Around the next double crochet, 2 single crochets. Around the next, that's on chain 3, 2 single crochets. We make 2 single crochets around each next row, around all the rows of the V stitches. The last 2 single crochet stitches are made in the row for the squares. I made my last 2 single crochets before we start on the square. In that chain 2 space, also 2 single crochets in that space. That's 1 and 2. In the next 32 stitches, 1 single crochet. That brings us to the next chain 2 space of the next corner of the square. This is the next chain 2 space of the square, 2 single crochets also in that space. After that chain 2 corner space, we work also a single crochet in the join stitch. Those stitches here on the top of the last join stitch in the middle. Go in your hook, grab your yarn, pull up and work a single crochet. Around the next 14 rows, around each double crochet, 2 single crochets. That's one. Round the next row. Two single crochets. That's two. Around the next row, two single crochets. That's three. 14 times in total. That's 28 single crochets around the rows of the double crochets. And this row here, color asen, we made our last two single crochets. We go further with single crochets. 4 times 2 single crochets around the chain 3 space of the light green color. That's here. That's 1 and 2 around the next stitch. That space here, 2 single crochets. That's 1 and 2, and in the next space 2 single crochets of the light green color. That's 3 times, and around the next space 2 single crochets. That's 4 times. Around the next color we make 4 times 2 single crochets around each space here, around each stitch. That's 2 and 2 single crochets. That's 3, and the last space, number 4, 2 single crochets. Around the next color, 6 times 2 single crochets around each chain space. That's 2, 6 times. That's 3, 4, 5, and the double crochet here, and 6, then 2 single crochets around the next double crochets here, of the gray color, we go further with single crochets, on the edge here, till we get to the gray color, the double crochet. We make 1 single crochet around the next double crochet of the gray color. That's here. Then around the next double crochet of the gray color, 2 single crochets. That's 1 and 2. 2 times 2 single crochets around the next double crochet of the pink color. Also here, 2 single crochets. Then 2 single crochets around the next double crochet of the gray color. That's 1 and 2. Once more around the gray color, 2 single crochets. That's 1 and 2. Also 2 times 2 single crochets around the next double crochet of the green color. That's 1 around the next green color, 2 stitches and 2. 3 times 2 single crochets around the next gray color. That's 1 and 2 single crochets. That's 2 and 2 single crochets. And that's 3. We made here 21 single crochets. The next part, we make that part till we get here. There we have to make 18 single crochets. We make 2 single crochets around the next color, the dark pink color, 1 and 2. And once more around the dark pink color, 2 single crochets, 1 and 2. A single crochet in the next stitch, then 2 single crochets around the next light green color, 1 and 2. Then we have to make in the next stitch 1 single crochet, 2 single crochets around the yellow color, 1 and 2. A single crochet into the next stitch, two single crochets around the gray color. One and two. A single crochet into the next stitch. Two single crochets around the next dark pink color. One and two. And then two single crochets around the dark purple. 18 single crochets in total. We work around the tulip stitches from here to here. That's 30 single crochets in total. We make two single crochets around the dark purple double crochet. That's one and two. Two single crochets around the light green color. That's one and two. Two single crochets around the dark green color. One and two. Two single crochets around the dark purple color. Then three single crochets around the dark purple color. That's one, two, and three. Two single crochets around the dark purple color. That's one and two. Two stitches around the yellow. One and two. Two stitches around the green color. One and two. Two single crochets around the dark purple. One and two. Three single crochets around the dark purple. One, two, and three. Two single crochets around the dark purple. One and two. Two single crochets around the pink color. One and two. Two single crochets around the green color. One and two. And the last two stitches are we made on the dark purple. That's 30 stitches in total. The next petal. Around the next 14 single crochets, we made one single crochet, 14 in total. Span. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, and the last one, 14. 14 single crochets. Single crochets from corner to corner of the granny square and around the pink color. 19 single crochets in total. We made a single crochet in the chain two corner space. Then on the granny square, 15 single crochets in total. That's on the top of each stitch. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Then in the chain 2 space, also one single crochet. Then a single crochet on the pink color. And the next pink color. That's 19 single crochets in total. We work 12 times 2 single crochets around the next double crochets of the granny stitches. these stitches here. 24 single crochets in total. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4 single crochets in total. That's 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8, 9 and 10, 11 and 12, 13 and 14, 15 and 16, 17 and 18, 19 and 20, 21 and 22, 23 and 24. 24 single crochets around the next two colors, the light and the dark green color. From here to here we make 21 single crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21 single crochets. Around the yellow stitches, 9 single crochets in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 9 single crochets. Around the next dark pink color, we make 18 single crochets in total. Bring us to the next corner. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and the last stitch, number 18. All the stitches we made along the long side are 304 single crochets in total. It's really important that you have a total of 304 stitches. Count your stitches. We make a corner and chain 2. And then on the top of the next 204 stitches we make 1 single crochet. But first we make the corner complete. The first stitch on the top of the first double crochet is this stitch here. it's really hard to get in that stitch. We go back in that chain 3 space. Make a single crochet to work that corner complete. Now on the top of the next 203 stitches, make one single crochet under to that whole V stitch, a single crochet. Work like this, all the single crochets to the end of this row that bring us to the next corner. I have to make one more last stitch, stitch 204. And now we create in that same stitch a corner, a chain 2, back in that same stitch with another single crochet. Now repeat all the stitches on the long side as we made the stitches on the other side. That's 304 stitches in total. We have here 18 single crochets around the dark pink, so you do that also on the other side. The yellow color, 9 single crochets, work also 9 single crochets around the next yellow stitches. And then here, around the light and the dark green color, 21 single crochets. Work these same stitches also on the other side. In total, 304 single crochets. I'm done with all the stitches on the second long side. We have to make a last corner. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and now we make a slip stitch on the top of the first standing single crochet here in the beginning. Yarn over, pull through, cut the yarn. And then weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. All the way around we have 1014 stitches in total. The next color is on the hook and then we can start on round 2. Don't turn your work, we will work in the front of the stitches in the next round. Round 2 and we start in a corner. This is the long side, the corner and the short side. This is the point, the corner where we start. We start in the corner for the short side. In that chain 2 space we make a new corner. The color is on the hook and we make a standing double crochet in that chain 2 corner space. Two more double crochets in that same chain 2 space. It's 1 and 2. We have here 3 double crochets. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same chain 2 corner space with another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And this is our first corner. The repeat of the short side of the blanket. We skip the next 2 stitches and then in the next stitch we make 3 double crochets in that same stitch. 1 and 2 skip stitches and then in the next stitch 3 double crochets. That's 1, 2, and 3, and we repeat this 68 times. Skip 2 stitches, in the next stitch 3 double crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3. Skip the next 2 stitches, in the next stitch 3 double crochets. Repeat all these stitches, groups of 3 double crochets, 60 times in total.
I have
68 groups of 3 double crochets. Now in that chain 2 corner space we make a new corner. 3 double crochets in that chain 2 space. Then in chain 2 and 3 double crochets back in that same chain 2 corner space. We work on the same way on the long side of the blanket. Skip the next 2 stitches, in the next stitch a group of 3 double crochets in that same stitch. And this 3 double crochets we repeat 101 times. Skip 2 stitches, in the next stitch 3 double crochet. Work all these stitches all the way around. At the end of this round, we have 346 clusters of 3 double crochets in the same stitch. In the beginning, we make an invisible join. Round 3. Turn your blanket, we look at the back of the stitches. And we begin in a chain 2 corner space with a new color on the hook, with a standing double crochet in that chain 2 space, and we make in that point a new corner. 2 double crochets more in that space. We have here our first group of 3 double crochets, then make a chain 2. Back in that same space with 3 double crochets to complete the first corner of round 3. Now we work all the way around between the next 2 clusters, a new cluster of 3 double crochet. Here's a cluster of 3 double crochets and the second, and between those 2 clusters in this space here we make a new cluster of 3 double crochets. One, 2, and 3. We skip the next cluster, and between the next 2 clusters in that space, a new group of a cluster of 3 double crochets in that space here. 1, 2, and 3. Between the next 2 clusters, 3 double crochets. Work like this all the way around. Every time between the next 2 clusters, a new cluster of 3 double crochets. In every corner, 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets. All the way around. In the beginning you make an invisible join, not in the first but in the second stitch. After you close round 3 with an invisible join, we make 4 more rounds at the same way. Round 8, do not turn your work. We look at the front of the stitches. Make a slip knot on the hook with a new color and we begin with a standing single crochet in a stitch. I choose one stitch here in the group for the first corner. Make a standing single crochet. Now in every stitch, make one single crochet until you get to the corner. My last stitch for the corner. Now in that chain two corner space, we make a new corner. One single crochet in that space and chain two. And back in that same space with another single crochet. And this is a new corner. And this is the way how we work all the way around. In every stitch on the top, under to that V stitch of a stitch, work one single crochet. And then in every corner, chain two corner space, a new corner of one single crochet, chain two, one single crochet. To close this round, make an invisible join in the beginning. Round 9, this is the final round of the blanket. We turn our blanket, we look at the back of the stitches. And we begin in a chain 2 corner space with a new color on the hook. And we begin with a standing double crochet in the chain 2 corner space. In that same corner space, 4 more double crochets. That's 1. 2, 3, and 4. We have here a new corner of 5 double crochets in that chain 2 space. The repeat of this round. Between the next two clusters of round 7, in this space here, we make one single crochet. And we work also around round 8. In that space here, one single crochet. Like this. Then we go to the next space of round 7 between the next two clusters and we make there a shell of 5 double crochets in that space, this space here. 5 double crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In the next space between the next two clusters, also a shell of 5 double crochets in that space. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then between the next two clusters in that space, one single crochet. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Two groups of 5 double crochets and then a single crochet. In the next space, 5 double crochets in that space. Is number 5. Between the next two clusters in that space also 5 double crochets. And then in the next space one single crochet. And this is the repeat you work all the way around. I made here my last single crochet, then in the next space we make 5 double crochets in that space, then a corner and then we start all over again. in the next space. 5 double crochets. That's the last space for the chain 2 corner space. Then in that chain 2 corner space, we make a new corner of 5 double crochets in that same space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Into the next space, 5 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Into the next space, we make only one single crochet. This is how it looks like in a corner. Start on the repeat of in the next two spaces 5 double crochets and in the next space 1 single crochet. In a next corner, you see that I'm work here for the corner only 1 single crochet. In that chain 2 corner space, we make a new corner of 5 double crochets in that space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we skip over to the next space and make 1 single crochet. And this is how it looks like in the other corner. It's a little bit different than the first corner that I work. Work like this all the way around, and then we close with an invisible join in the beginning, and then we're done. This is what it looks like in the next corner. 5 double crochets, 5 double crochets in the corner, 5 double crochets, and then a single crochet, and then start all over with the repeat. I'm all the way around. I made my last single crochet here for the corner, then we work 5 double crochets in the corner. Cut the yarn, open up that stitch, and we make an invisible join to close this round. And then we're done with the blanket. Skip the first stitch, go to the second stitch, under to that V stitch, pull through, back to the last stitch, and that's the single crochet. Then only in the back loop of that single crochet. On the back, you make a little knot and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. And we're done. Our blanket is complete. I loved working on this blanket. I hope you do too. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!